All right, guys, what's going on? This is the last one of these notes. I've had these notes for weeks and I haven't been able to like put them up. So I just kind of ended with the importance of understanding plyometrics, loading and unloading. So I'm going to pick up there, but today's t-shirt is the Caribbean. Definitely one of my favorite places in the world. This particular shirt came from Saint Martin, where the French are, and we were just doing some injury prevention stretching and hanging out in the ocean. It was good. I love that part of the world. It's nice and warm. So, plyometrics, loading and unloading. That's what happens every single time you jump, every single stride you take. It's a load, unload. So, when is the best time to do that? Well, the best time is during your recovery time. So, when you lift, right after you lift, you want to create a plyometric. It could be as simple as running a little sprint, or doing some hops, or going and touch the rim three times, or something. You need to do something to compensate for all of that force that you just ran through your body. The body creates greater levels of energy stores to compensate for all the demand. So that's basically what happens. And test it out. Don't take my word for it. Test it out. Everything I say, test it out. So here's the thing. Your body is one muscle. Okay, your body is one muscle. And so you have the front side and you have the back side, but it's still all one muscle. And it's all one mind controlling it. So anatomical individuality, yes. Functional individuality, no. So in other words, you want to begin to understand that your body is a whole unit, not just biceps, triceps, hamstrings, whatever. You can't basically isolate the body because one thing affects something else. So if you train with that in mind, then you're going to get different results. Okay? I mentioned earlier about the blood and the bones. They are very intimate partners. So if you're not getting good nutrition in your body, then it's going to affect your blood and your bones. Now, that maybe has nothing to do with vertical or speed, but in the long run, it has something to do with its, what's even more important, which is your health. So understanding what you're feeding your body is affecting your blood and your bones, okay? And then what and how that's affecting you is how the energy is delivered to your body. So it's a big deal to understand how you take care of your body is really going to create the results that you get. Connective tissues are everything. Connective tissues are everything. They can be all kind of, they can be watery, they can be elastic, they can be solid, okay, or they can be like wire. So making sure that you get enough hydration when you're training is important because it's, again, it's your connective tissue. And remember I mentioned ischemia back a couple videos. Without proper hydration, you're doomed. You just aren't going to get far because your connective tissue isn't going to be able to expand and contract like you want it. Okay? Inside these blood and bones, again, you have a storehouse of calcium and phosphorus. Calcium and phosphorus is what feeds into the ATP system. So you can't necessarily put inorganic calcium and inorganic phosphorus in your body and expect your body to respond. You got to get it from good food choices. Okay? It's important that you nourish your body with good stuff. I did a video a few years ago where I was in an herb shop. And I got the ginseng formulas and the teas. And I was making teas because I was making sure that I put stuff in my body that could strengthen my bones. So if you're eating foods that are not wholesome, it's going to affect you in the long run. It's going to affect the fiber, the fabric of your tissues. And in order for you to really get the highest quality out of your life, you need to make sure that you're putting the highest quality in. For example, Kobe Bryant just injured his wrist, right? He went to Germany, and they took out and extracted blood from his injury, cleaned out the blood, and put it back in his body. That's amazing. So they basically increased his body to heal itself. So that's what he's doing on such a high level. What you can do is just making sure that you get fruits and vegetables, nuts and seeds, stay away from the milk, you know, stay away from the sodas. Really begin to make good food choices, because if you're training hard, you need to be eating good food. All right, this is Coach Selby. I'm checking out. I'm looking forward to your comments, your questions, and getting some dialogue going. All right, guys, have a great day.